Hello students, welcome to today's video classroom. Subject computer science, paper programming in C++. Today topic sorting arrays. So in previous class we had discussed how arrays are useful in searching. Today we are going to discuss how arrays are useful for sorting. So we have studied that when we need to store multiple values in a single variable, we use a concept of arrays. So for example, I have a hundred values of the same data type. These values need to be arranged in a particular order, either ascending order or descending order. So that is called as a sorting. Any elements ni either ascending order lo gaani, descending order lo gaani అరేంజ్ చేయడానికి మనం ఏమంటాము సార్టింగ్ ప్రాసెస్ అంటాం. సార్టింగ్ ఈజ్ ఎ ప్రాసెస్ ఆఫ్ అరేంజింగ్ ఎ సెట్ ఆఫ్ డాటా ఇన్ సమ్ ఆర్డర్. సో దెర్ ఆర్ ద డిఫరెంట్ మెథడ్స్ టు సార్ట్ ద డాటా ఎదర్ ఇన్ అసెండింగ్ ఆర్డర్ ఆర్ డిసెండింగ్ ఆర్డర్. సో జనరల్ టాపిక్స్ ఆర్ బబుల్ సార్ట్, సెలక్షన్ సార్ట్, ఇన్సర్షన్ సార్ట్, క్విక్ సార్ట్, మెర్జ్ సార్ట్, హీప్ సార్ట్. So like this, there are the different sorting techniques are there. So as per our syllabus, the most common sorting techniques are the bubble sort and selection sort. We can see remaining sorting techniques in the third stream data structure concept. Now we'll see how the elements are arranged in a ascending order using bubble sort. So generally, in the all the sorting techniques, the bubble sort is a very simple sorting technique, but it is very slowest. It very slowest. That means it will sort the elements in very slowly. So because the bubble sort compares each item in the list with next to it and swapping them if they required. So for example, how the bubble sort will work. So manamu class lo students anta kuchunnaru bench ku kuchunnaru. So I want to arrange them in the అసెండింగ్ ఆర్డర్ ఆఫ్ దేర్ హైట్స్. అలా హైట్ ఆధారంగా అసెండింగ్ ఆర్డర్లో సెట్ చేయాలనుకున్నాం. ఏం చేస్తుందంటే ఇక్కడ మనము బబుల్ సార్ట్ ఏం చేస్తుందంటే ఫస్ట్ బెంచ్లో కూర్చున్న స్టూడెంట్ని సెకండ్ బెంచ్లో కూర్చున్న స్టూడెంట్స్తో కంపేర్ చేస్తాం. వాళ్ళిద్దరిట్లో ఎవరు కంపేర్ చేస్తాం. మనకు కావాల్సింది అసెండింగ్ ఆర్డర్లో స్టోర్ చేయాలంటే ఫస్ట్ బెంచ్లో ఉన్న స్టూడెంటు స్మాల్ హైట్ ఉండాలి, సెకండ్ బెంచ్లో ఉన్న స్టూడెంటు హైయెస్ట్లో ఉండాలి. వాళ్ళిద్దరిని కంపేర్ చేస్తాం ఫస్ట్. సే ఇయర్ అంటే ఫస్ట్ బెంచ్ స్టూడెంట్ని, సెకండ్ బెంచ్ స్టూడెంట్ని, థర్డ్ బెంచ్ ఇలా అందరు కూడా కూర్చున్నాం. సో వాట్ విల్ యూ డూ? ఫస్ట్ విల్ కంపేర్ దిస్ టూ థింగ్స్ ఫస్ట్. సో దెన్ ఇఫ్ దిస్ పర్సన్ ఈజ్ గ్రేటర్ దెన్ దిస్ పర్సన్ విల్ ఎక్స్చేంజ్, అదర్వైజ్ నో నీడ్ టు ఎక్స్చేంజ్. అగైన్ విల్ కంపేర్ దిస్ టూ థింగ్స్. సో దిస్ ఈజ్ కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ఎ బబుల్ సార్ట్. This is called. That means that if you take an array, the array size is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, array size is 4. So here, for example, the values are the 10, 5, 12, 13, 9. So these elements need to be stored in the ascending order. What we have to do is that we have to compare the 0th element with the first element. What is the 0th element? 10 0th element is compared with the first element. So what we have to do? So actually, to make the elements in the ascending order, the first element must be less than, the second element must be greater than. What we have to do? Whether a of 0 is greater than a of 1? If it is true, we have to exchange the values. Yes, a of 0. What is a of 0? 10. 10 greater than 5? Yes, we have to exchange the values. Now the array is 5. 10, 12, 13, 9. This does not change. Only 2 matre change avutundi. Again, what we have to do? Again, first element is compared with the second element. What is the first element? This. Now, 10 is the first element. Again, compare these two things. 10 greater than 12? 10 greater than 12? No. Don't do that again. Again, what you have to do? 12 compare with the 1. 13. 12 greater than 13? No. Again, compare the 13 with the 9. 13 greater than 9? Yes, move the 13 to the back. So now after the first iteration, 5, 10, 12, 9, 13. So like this, the elements. So the first iteration is completed. So at the end of the first iteration, the largest element is placed at the last position. So again, from the starting onwards, again compare the zeroth element with the first element, again first element with the second element with the third element. At the second iteration, the 12 is placed at the year. Again, in the third iteration, zeroth element is the first element, first with the second. So this process will be continue as long as the test can all the elements in the array are placed at the correct position. That means, if there are the n elements in the array, we require the n minus 1 iterations. So generally, the bubble sort structure will be like this. If there are the 5 elements, we have to compare these two things, again compare these two things, again compare these two things, again compare these two things. This is the first iteration close. So after comparing this, the largest element is placed at the last position. Again in the second iteration, the zeroth element, first with second, second with third, all completion. Again third iteration, zeroth element is the first, first with second. So like this, this process will become, this is called as a bubble sort. Next, selection sort. The selection sort is also a very simple sorting technique, but is faster than the bubble sort, but it is slower than the remaining sorts. What is that? The selection sort algorithm construct a sorted sequence one element at a time by adding the elements to the sorted sequence in the order. So at each sequence step, what we have to do is that we have to find out the smallest element and add to the remaining element. That means, at each step, next element to be added to the sorted sequence is selected from the remaining element. That means that, so here, let's take an array directly. So 10, 5, 12, 13, 14. What we'll do is that, first we'll select what is the smallest element in this list. How to find out smallest element? I will take the zeroth element as a smallest element and I will compare with this all those elements. The zeroth element is compared with the all the elements in the list. If you found any element less than the 0, 10, and if you found any element less than the 10, so we will swap those two things only. So for example, the let's array is like this, 10, 14, 11, 9, 12. So what will do? The 10 is compared with the 14. 14 less than 10? No. Again, 10 is compared with the 11. 11 less than 10? No. Again, 10 is compared with the 9. Yes. 10 greater than the 9? Yes, sorry, 9 less than 10, yes, those are the interchanged. 9 will be come here, 14 will be come here, 11 here, 10 will be here, 12 is. So those two are the interchanged. So now at the end of the first iteration, the smallest element is placed in the first position. Now we will take the second element, 14. Now we will element find out the which is the less than the 14. Again, is there. Okay, 14 less than 10, 14 less than 10. Again, is the other elements? 11 less than 10, yes, 10 will be placed here. Like this, the elements will be sorted. Okay, here, what is the, in the selection of sort, there are the two steps. In the first step, find the smallest element in the list. Find the smallest element in the list. In the second step, swap the smallest element with the element at the first position. Okay. There are the two steps in the selection sort. First thing is that find the smallest element in the list and swap the smallest element in the proper position. Then find the next smallest element and swap with the element at the second position. Then you have to repeat this process. That means to find the minimum value. How to find out the smallest element? First take the zeroth element as a minimum element. Now compare this, the minimum element, with all the elements next to it. If you found any element less than the first element, take the new element as a minimum element. Now again compare the, this minimum element with the next element. That means, see, 9, so let's just remind the concept, understand the concept. So 9, 11, 14, 12, 9, 8. So this is the minimum, first number I take a zeroth element as taken as a minimum element. Now compare this element with the, all the elements, find the minimum element. So here 14 is less than 10, no. 12 less than 10, no. 9 less than 10, yes. Now 9 is the minimum element. Now compare the this minimum element with the next element. If it is less than minimum element, take new element as a minimum element. Now 9 is the minimum element. Now again compare this minimum element. 9 the remaining element in list lo unnai, dantho compare chestam. Yes, 8 less than 9, yes. Now comparing to 8 is the minimum. Now swap these two things. So this is a selection sort. Simply, the selection sort does the two things. One is that find the smallest element. Next, place the smallest element in the, its proper position. So this is called as a selection sorting technique. These are the two sorting techniques, bubble sort and selection sorting techniques. Okay. So in the next class, we'll go for the concept of the pointers.